Welcome dear students, today we are going to discuss surfactants and the pharmaceutical applications. Now what exactly these surfactants? These surfactants are also known as a wetting agent, emulsifying agent, suspending agent. Depending upon their properties and use, they can be used. Surface active agents are a substances which at a low concentration adsorb onto the surface or interface. Surface and second term is interface, means a line or a faces between two liquid which are immiscible in nature, and at that surface or interface your surfactant get adsorbed and it alter surface and interfacial free energy, and the surface or interfacial tension. Okay, means surface tension at interface or surface can be changed by using this surface active agent within low concentration. Surfactants are monomers. It has a characteristic structure processing both hydrophobic, that is non-polar region, usually contain C12 to C18 hydrocarbon chain, and hydrophilic group, it is also known as a polar region or polar heads. Therefore, they are soluble in both organic solvents and water. So, they are called amphiphilic means which is having a property partially like hydrophobic substances and hydrophilic substances. This is hydrophilic head of surfactant and this is hydrophobic tail. This is structure of monomer of surfactant. Now we'll see mechanism of action, how surfactants acts. Now surfactants are acting in a three different ways. First one is roll up mechanism, second one is emulsification, and third one is solubilization. In a roll up mechanism, the surfactant lowers oil and solution and fabric solution interfacial tension, and in this way it try to lift up the strength from the fabrics. Okay, this roll up mechanism most probably used in a detergent which are helpful to remove strain from your fabric. Second mechanism, that is emulsification. This surfactant lowers oil solution interfacial tension and make easy emulsification of oil, and that's why we can easily remove this oil, or we can easily become this oil miscible with other solvent because of decrease in surface tension between your oil phase and water phase. Third mechanism is nothing but solubilization. In a solubilization, through interaction with micelle, a surfactant in a solvent, a substance spontaneously dissolve to form a stable and clear solution. This is a diagrammatic representation of roll up mechanism, and this one is for emulsification. Okay, if you observe it, surfactant forms a layer around its stain, and it try to lift up that stain from these fabrics. This is known as the roll up mechanism. And second mechanism is emulsification. This surface acting agent acts on this stain or form a layer on this stain, and they try to increase miscibility. Then classification of surface active agents or surfactants. It is totally based on charge group present on their heads. A non-ionic surfactant do not have any charge group over its head. The head of an ionic surfactant carries a net charge. If charge is negative, surfactant is more specifically called anionic. And if a charge is positive, then it is called as cationic. Means depending upon nature of charge, they are categorized into anionic and cationic type surfactant. If surfactant contains a head with two oppositely charged group, it is termed as deuterion. Means surfactant which consists of both the ion, cation as well as anion, is called as deuterion. Classification of the surfactant: anionic surfactant, cationic surfactant, then non-ionic surfactant, and last one is deuterionic or amphoteric surfactant. This deuterionic surfactant is also known as the amphoteric surfactant. Now we'll see one by one. In anionic surfactant, head is negatively charged. Okay, we have discussed the structure of monomer. It consists of head and tail. In case of anionic surfactant, this head is negatively charged, and these surfactants are the most widely used for preparing shampoos because its excellent cleaning property and high hair conditioning effect. Anionic surfactants are particularly effective at oil cleansing and oil or clay suspension. This is structural representation of anionic surfactant. The most commonly used anionic surfactants are alkyl sulfates, alkyl ethoxylate, sulfates and soaps. Most of anionic surfactants are carboxylate, sulfate and sulfonate ions. These are the different example of anionic surfactant. Then straight chain, a saturated, unsaturated or unsaturated, C12 or C18, C12 to C18 aliphatic group, the water solubility potential of surfactant is determined by the presence of double bond. The second type is cationic surfactants. In cationic surfactants, now head of this monomer is positively charged. These cationic surfactants are quaternary ammonium compound and they are mostly used for their disinfectant and preservative properties as they have a good antibacterial property or bactericidal activity. They are used on the skin for cleansing a wound or burns. Mostly used cationic surfactants are citramides, which has a tetradecyl trimethyl ammonium bromide with minimum amount of dodecyl and hexadecyl compounds. Other cationic surfactants like benzalkonium chloride, then cetyl pyridinium chlorides are also used. Then third type of surfactant is non-ionic surfactant. These surfactants do not have any electrical charge, which makes them resistant to water hardness deactivation. They are less irritant than other type like anionic and cationic surfactant. The hydrophilic part contain polyoxyethylene, then polyoxypropylene or polyol derivatives. Then hydrophobic part of this non-ionic surfactant contains saturated or unsaturated fatty acid or fatty alcohols. They are excellent grease remover and emulsifier. The non-ionic surfactants can be classified as polyolesters, then polyoxy esters. Then polyoxyethylene esters. Then polyoxomers. The polyol esters include glycol, glycerol esters and sorbitan derivatives. Then polyoxyethylene esters include polyoxyethylene glycol like PEG40, PEG50, PEG55. The most commonly used non-ionic surfactants are ethers of fatty alcohol, then last class of this surfactant is amphoteric or zwitterionic surfactant. Now these surfactants are very mild, making them particularly suited for use in a personal care preparation over sensitive skin. They can be anionic or non-ionic in solution depending on acidity or pH of water, or cationic in nature. Means these amphoteric surfactants can be anionic, can be cationic or non-ionic in nature. Its nature is totally depend upon pH of water and acidity. Those surfactants may contain two charge groups of different sign, whereas positive charge is almost always ammonium, but source of negative charge may vary. Means in case of this amphoteric surfactant, positively charged entity is always ammonia group, but this negative charge may vary. Either it is carboxylate, either it is sulfate or sulfonate. These surfactants have excellent dermatological properties. They are frequently used in shampoos and other cosmetic products, and also in a hand washing liquid because of their high foaming properties. This is structure of amphoteric surfactant. Example of alkene, betaine. Okay, if you observe this diagram carefully, it is having a positive charge and positively charged nitrogen and negatively charged oxygen. Then properties of surfactants: wetting of solids, solubilization, emulsification, then dispersion of solid in solution, then micellization and detergency. These are the different properties of surfactants. Now we'll see one by one. First is micellization. Now before this micellization, we'll see what exactly micelle. A micelle is an aggregate of surfactant molecules dispersed in liquid collides, and the process of forming a micelle is known as the micellization. Okay, this micelle formation in polar and non-polar solvent depends on concentration of surfactant in a particular solvent. If add a surfactant that is monomer in a solvent at a low concentration, some monomer disperse in a solvent or aggregate at a surface or interface until all surface or interface saturated by surfactants. Further addition of surfactant increase a concentration of monomer and it goes in a solvent and start to form a micelle. That monomer forms aggregate like structure, and that aggregate like structure is nothing but micelle. This concentration is called critical micelle concentration or CMC. Okay, means when you add this surfactant continuously in particular solvent, either it is polar or non-polar. Initially it is dispersed in the solvent, then after addition of more amount of this solvent, more amount of this surfactant into the solvent, it start to aggregate, it start to form a micelle. Micelle is nothing but just aggregation of these monomers, and the concentration at which it start to produce micelle is known as critical micelle concentration. Okay, this is known as the critical micelle concentration. Okay, if you observe this diagram carefully, first of all, it is the solution of your dilute surfactant. Then, more after addition of more surfactant, it looks like this second diagram. Then, if you add more surfactant, then it forms micelle. And the concentration at which it forms a micelle is known as critical micelle concentration of that particular surfactant into the solvent. Okay, the monomer concentration of monomer at which the micelle are start to form in a solvent at a particular temperature is nothing but your CMC. Greater concentration is required to form this CMC. Okay, initially it is extremely dilute solution, then it is dispersed into the solution. When you add more amount, then it become dilute. Okay, and further addition of your surfactant, when you achieve your CMC concentration, it start to form micelle, and then you will get a more micelle when you add more amount of this surfactant into the solvent. Then wetting of solids, a drop of liquid when placed on a flat homogeneous solid surface comes to equilibrium assuming a shape which minimizes total free energy of the system. Okay, then an angle between liquid and solid is called contact angle, is also denoted by theta, and angle being measured through the liquid. The contact angle may be calculated if surface and interfacial tension are known from Young's equation. This is equation for determination of contact angle. This is equation 1, equation 2, that cos theta is equal to gamma SA minus gamma SL divided by gamma LA, where this gamma LA is surface tension of liquid, gamma SL is an interfacial tension existing between solid and liquid, and gamma SA is surface tension of solids. If theta is less than 90, then wetting of solid is said to be takes place. But if this theta is greater than 90, wetting does not takes place. Okay, means your solid does not become wet with that solvent. The term wetting agent is applied to any substance that increase a ability of water or an aqueous solution to displace air from a liquid or a solid surface. For good wetting, cos theta should be as close as possible to 1, then it will give you good wetting property. Means when you put this drop of liquid on surface of plate, it will give you a contact angle, and that contact angle is nothing but theta, and when this cos theta is close to 1, then it is a property of good surfactant, or your surfactant is having a good wetting property. this is your contact angle this is your drop of liquid and this is your surface, and because of this drop of liquid there is a formation of angle between your plate and drop of liquid, and this angle is nothing but your theta. Here it is more, here it is less than 90, here it is greater than 90. Then emulsification. This is a property of surfactants to form a stable emulsion of two or more immiscible liquids. When oil and water mix together and agitated, droplets of varying size are formed. Okay, when you try this, if you have oil with you and water with you and you try to mix it or you are shake it vigorously, droplets of your oil disperse into the water. But after putting it for 10 to 15 minutes, again it try to separate. Okay, again it get forms two layers, one layer of oil and second layer of water, because there is a difference between the because of this oil and water is immiscible with each other. Now what exactly the role of this surfactant? This surfactant decreases interfacial tension between the molecules of two different solvents, either it is oil or either it is water. Okay, these molecules try to decrease interfacial tension between these two different molecules, and your oil try to become miscible with this water. Okay, then tension exists at this interface because of these two immiscible liquid phases tends to have a different attractive forces for molecules at the interface. Okay, because of this force of attraction they are immiscible with each other, but the molecules at one phase are repelled by other phase due to the greater interfacial tension. And role of this surfactant is reduction of this interfacial tension. Now this is done by addition of surfactant and surfactant having a following mechanism. First, that is reduction of interfacial tension. Second, formation of interfacial film. And third one is formation of electrical double layer. Okay, these are the three different mechanisms. By using these three different mechanism, we can decrease interfacial tension between oil and water. Now second, next part is interfacial tension. Now what exactly is interfacial tension? As we have discussed, this reduction of this interfacial tension lowers interfacial free energy produced on dispersion. Then the surfactants are adsorbing on the interface of these two liquids. Hydrophilic head have an affinity towards water and hydrophobic tail having an affinity towards the oil, and this is responsible for the reduction of interfacial tension of two immiscible phases. And because of this decrease of interfacial tension will become this liquid miscible with each other. Then interfacial film, the formation of film by these emulsifiers or surfactants is similar to the adsorption of surfactant at interface of your oil and water. If concentration of this emulsifier is high enough to form a rigid film between immiscible phases, which acts as a mechanical barrier to both adhesion and emulsifier of emulsion droplet. And in O by W emulsion, the mixture of sodium cetyl sulfate and cholesterol form more stable interfacial film. Then electrical repulsion or electrical double layer formation. It has just been described how interfacial film significantly alter a rate of coalescence of droplets. Because of this coalescence, phases become separated. If you have oil and water with you, by acting as a barrier. In addition, the same or similar film can produce repulsive electric forces between approaching droplets, and such a repulsion is due to an electrical double layer which may arises from electrically charged groups and orients on the surface of emulsified globules. Okay, means this electrical repulsion is helpful for the miscibility. Then next is solubilization. The preparation of thermodynamically stable isotropic solution of substance normally insoluble or very slightly soluble in a given solvent by introduction of an additional amphiphilic component or components is known as solubilization. The amphiphilic components must be introduced at a concentration at which or above their CMC. It means you have to add surfactant in a such a way that its concentration should be more than critical micellar concentration. Simple micellar system as well as liquid crystalline phases and vesicles referred to above are all capable of solubilization. When you add this concentration of your surfactant more than the CMC, then it helpful for the solubilization of substance into the this particular liquid. In a liquid crystalline phases and vesicles, a ternary system is formed on incorporation of solubilizate, and thus this anisotropic system are not strictly in accordance with definition. Now, solubilization by micelle formation. The location of solubilized molecule in micelle is determined primarily by chemical structure of solubilizate. Then solubilization can occur at a number of different sites in a micelle. Okay, first is on a surface at a micelle solvent interface, at a surface and between hydrophilic head groups, in a palisade layer. Okay, palisade layers means beneath layer present to the surface between hydrophilic group and first few carbon atoms of hydrophobic groups that comprises the outer region of the micellar core. More deeply in a palisade layer and in a micellar inner core, these are the different sites where these micelle acts and increases solubilization. Now, example of this solubilization, for example, polar alcohols are soluble in aqueous solution, then phenol are having a polar OH group and non-polar benzene ring is there in which this hydroxy group located in hydrophilic environment and the benzene ring in hydrophobic environment. So it located at the surface and between hydrophilic head groups. Then semipolar material like fatty acids usually located on palisade layer. The depth of this penetration depending on ratio of the polar and non-polar structures in solubilized molecule. Then non-polar additives such as hydrocarbon tends to be intimately associated with hydrocarbon core of micelle. Then pharmaceutical examples of the solubilization of phenolic compound like chrysol, chlorocrysol for the formation of disinfectant. Then solubilization of solution of iodine in non-ionic surfactants for use in a sterilization process. then solubilization of drugs like steroids, vitamins and essential oils by non-ionic surfactants. Then most important property of the surface active agent, that is detergent property. Then this detergency is most commonly used for the cleansing and removing grease and oil dirt from the solid surface. Then this process needs many actions specific to surfactant molecules. This surfactant requires good wetting property, then we can say that, or it can ensure this good contact with its surface, solid surface, and it will helpful to remove dirt from the solid surface. It also has the ability to remove dirt from bulk liquid. Then this property achieved by lowering surface tension of the medium in which surfactant is dissolved, then lowering interfacial tension between two media or interface, and the surfactant plays an important role in a removal and a suspension of dirt. Then this lowering of surface tension of water make it easier to lift a dirt and grease from the dirty dishes, clothes and other surfaces, and help to keep suspended in a dirty water. Then water loving and hydrophilic head remain in water, and it pull this stain towards the water and away from the fabric. Okay, if with the help of the surface active agent we can remove stain from clothes. Then surfactant molecules surround these stain particles, break them and force them away from the surface of this fabric. Then they suspend the stain particles in washed water to remove them. If dirt is oily, it may emulsify and solubilize by surfactants. Okay, these are the different application of solubilization. Thank you.